You know what the problem is, Tommy?
What?
There are so many wannabe MCs. But if you want to be a real one, you go face killer.
This shit is big time!
Who is Randy?
Don't bring anyone loving to this.
Your mom in the fucking stand!
Welcome to your mom's house. With Tom Segura.
And Christina Pajitsky.
Welcome to your mom's house.
Oh, shit. God damn. Feels good. Feels good. Good to be back. All right, let's state the obvious first. Well, first of all, welcome. Welcome again to your mom's house. How does this sound? I have no fucking idea. I don't know. That's what I'm going to talk to you about. Welcome back to your mom's house, to our loyal mommies. It's good to be back. It's good for. I'm sure it's good for you to hear your mommy's voice. To our new listeners, welcome. This is a bizarre way to start off at a new place because this is not even the full squad. This is your mom's house with Tom Segura and Christina Pajitsky. And as you can tell by your ears, she's not here. So, yeah, we have been busting our ass for a while trying to get this shit going. And the whole point of actually doing this one is just to have something there, just to put something up, give you guys something to listen to, let you know that we are serious about this. This has been a motherfucker to put together. And you might be like, why is that? What's the struggle, man? Well, here's what happened to everybody. You know, I want to give you a backstory, let you know what's going on. If you're a new listener, we were at, Death Squad, Red Band's, podcast empire for a year. And, as we explained in the last episode 40, we decided that we wanted to just do it from home from now on, mostly just out of convenience. And, in case you're wondering, we are still, good friends with Red Band, and we're still, dear friends with everybody at Death Squad, and that whole relationship is good. So there's no, like, ill will, there's nothing bad. If you're thinking that there is, you're wrong. There's everything's good. But anyways, the journey to try to get this from our home, you know, a lot of podcasts are just people talking as I am right now, and all you need is a couple mics and like a digital recorder, like a Zoom or something like that, which I have. You know, I've done solo couch casts before into my phone. The quality sounds like shit. I don't even know how this sounds. That's the thing. I have no idea. If this doesn't sound good, I'm sorry. But here's what, anyways, we wanted to not give you a show with low shit production quality. We wanted it to be a high quality show. And the only way to do that is to spend the money and also to learn technical shit that I have no idea how to do. So what do I have? I have a mixing board with all kinds of lights and gay gadgets and things on them. I don't know what any of them mean. There's how many cables am I looking at? 38 cables. I don't know what they do. I don't know where they go. I have spent a small fortune putting this thing together and just waiting and asking, oh, here's what it did. So I got all this shit and we're like, all right, we'll do it now. Now, one of the things, if you're a listener from before, you'll know this. And if you're a new listener, you'll find that out. We love, you know, audio clips. We have segments that we play audio clips. It's become part of the show, and it's fun, and I never want to stop doing that. I love doing that. So obviously you have to be able to play those. We can't just talk and have that. We got to be able to play our clips. That also was something where I was like, how do you make a clip work into this thing? And people were like, oh, it's easy. Just get that one cable, plug it in. And then I'd be like, but now what? So since we talked on the last Death Squad show, I've just been asking people to come help me out. And, of course, all the people that I know that know shit like this would be like, Yeah, no, I mean, I can come tomorrow. Okay, what time? Noon? And then the next day I'd be like, hey, it's noon. And they'd be like, yeah, the thing is I can't come today anymore. And it's just been a fucking endless cycle of people telling me that they were going to come and then they didn't come. And finally today, my good buddy, Matt Cohen from Smodcast Network, Kevin Smith's network, came over and he fucking hooked me up and taught me not how to be retarded. And he also, I learned, taught himself this shit. I thought he was just like Mr. Technical. Nope. He's a comic and a improviser and, you know, UCB guy. And I was like, what? You just learned yourself? And he was like, yeah, stop being stupid. So that's that. So now the shit's working. Christina, why is she not here? She just got on a plane like an hour ago. She's in San Jose. By the time this is up, she will not be in San Jose, but that's where she is right now. And the reason that we decided to go about the first episode without the two of us is just, like I said, just to get the ball rolling, have it up there, and then it'll be easier to continue. So anyways, that is that's the status of that. And fuck, it sucks, man. It sucks not knowing how to do technical shit or handy shit. I used to be the person who, if I got something at IKEA, I would just call a friend and be like, I'll give you like a 6-pack if you'll put that together. That's how much I was not willing to try. And this time I had to really, and I started, you know, building things. Now I build decks, furniture. If you need something to do with something carpentry based, I'll do it. Look up Tom Segura Furniture online. I have a collection of things that I'd really like to sell to you. That's where we are now. We are at this place where we have this wonderful podcast, and we're going to do it a lot, man. I know people were asking, of course, how could I not address the thing that people were fucking hammering me for that we're not doing clearly right now, which is video. Are we going to do video? Yes. Why is there no video on this one? Because I don't know what to fucking do. And it's taken me fucking forever to get this far, to just be able to talk to you like this. So there's not video right now. I am aware of that. There's going to be video. I fucking promise you we'll have video. I have the cameras. I don't know what cables I need. I don't know what would go into where. I have friends that have told me that, you know, how they can do it, I'm fucking sorry, but anyways, sorry, this is, I'm looking at all the shit in front of me, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing, but I am excited to be here. Now, what can I tell you? I did Joe Rogan's podcast yesterday, the Joe Rogan Experience, which is should be, by the time this is up, it's definitely going to be up. Let me figure out which one it is so I can refer to the correct episode. It is episode 185. If you listen to episode 185, I tell the story of the first time I bought drugs. The first time I bought drugs, like a real drug deal, or the real drug dealers, was when I was 14. And it's best to go and listen to episode 185. And it's towards the end. It's like one of the last things we talk about. So I won't, you know, just I'll give you the heads up. So I go and I buy drugs from this guy. And I was scared to death. And the guy's name was Pat. And he lived out in a trailer in Fort Pierce, which is in Florida on the East Coast. And he lived off of a dirt road. And I thought I was going to die. And then he told me to take care of his place, to watch it for him while he was gone, which I was like, okay. And then he was like, but if anyone comes in, because he left me at his home to go get drugs. He didn't have the drugs. Like, we drove all this way to get drugs from this guy. And then he was like, but we got to go get it somewhere else. And then he didn't have drugs. He had to go get them too. But he wanted me to watch his place as a 14-year-old. And then he had guns laying out. He was like, if anyone comes in, shoot them. Shoot anybody that comes in. And I was like, yeah, cool. And then he was like, bud, don't shoot my mama. If you shoot my mama, that would be fucked up. And I was like, I won't shoot your mama. So anyways, I told the story in much more detail on the Joe Rogan Experience episode 185. And I already got people who listened to the live version ask me, is that real? Yes, it's real. It's a true story. And when I went to get the drugs, I went with my friend Steve. I called and I said, we got to recap this. So people want to know if it's real. And so he was kind enough to let me record him. And I recorded him like off of a phone into a thing. So yeah, I know it doesn't sound fucking perfect, but this is a real story, and it's funny and it's fun. So here is my buddy Steve and I talking on the phone, recapping what it was like to buy drugs from Pat Pat. You can just, you know, judge for yourself how fantastic Pat Pat was. Okay, hold on a second. Give me a fucking second. Go fuck yourself. And we're rolling. Okay, Steve, so a lot of people are responding to the story I told on the Joe Rogan Experience about Pat Pat, who you so kindly introduced me to when we were 14 years old. And they're asking me if it's a true story. Now, I know you haven't had a chance to listen to how I told it on there, but what's your recollection of the first time? That's the first time you met him too, right?
You know, I think I may have met Pat Pat once or twice before, but just on a very quick in and out through a friend that I knew. So I think with you and I together was the first time we got to really know what Pat Pat's all about, for sure.
How would you describe,
well, first of all, when I told you that I told the story, I told you about how that guy White Pete came, and you were like, hold on, I don't know if that's his name. But you also have the memory of an Alzheimer's patient, and you also don't recall his name, but you did describe him as a white what?
I call him a white Snoop Dogg. He looks like Snoop Doggy Dog.
Snoop Dogg, a white Snoop Dogg.
White Snoop Dogg, yes.
Okay.
For sure.
So even if I have the name wrong, which I don't think I do, I'm describing him correctly as a guy who was basically black, but he was white, right?
Absolutely, definitely. Yeah, it doesn't get any blacker than that other than his skin was white.
And then we got in his car, and I thought we were just going to get weed in the back seat of his car, and he was like, let's roll. I was like, roll where? And then we end up going to Fort Pierce. And do you remember where Papa's house was, or his trailer?
I do. He lived in, it was weird, actually, very weird. He lived in the boondocks off of Long Country Road in a little mobile home out in the middle of nowhere. I believe, if I remember right, that he had this junkyard dogs running around and the whole thing. It wasn't an inviting place to visit.
There was absolutely nothing nearby. Like, if they wanted to bound us and gut us and fuck us, like, by a canal, there was no getting out of that. You realize that, right?
Hell no. We were toast, man. We really wanted that weed bad.
Now, can I ask you this? Because I've never actually even asked. I don't know if I've ever asked you this. Maybe we talked about it, but I was telling them yesterday that the one thing about that incident that really stands out to me was the amount of fear that I felt. Like, I was really fucking scared, man. Were you scared?
You were scared going to his house, or were you scared with what happened when we went down to Avenue D?
Well, that's a separate thing, but going to his house, I was like, I mean, I would just say I was unsure. When we pulled up and we got out and they opened the door and he's like, oh, this is Pat Pat place right here. And then Pat Pat was like, what's up, Pete? Or what's up, White Pete? Or whatever he said. And then he was like, yo, man, these boys looking for a sack. And then I was like, oh, shit. I would say I was nervous then. When he left me at his trailer to guard the place while you guys went to get weed, I was scared to death, man.
I don't blame you. I mean, it was definitely an awkward situation. But you know what? Now that you're talking about the sports coming back to me, and I had been there before, I think that's why he wanted me to go with him to the other location and leave you behind. I didn't expect him to leave you behind. That was pretty crazy, but at the time, there was no arguing with Pat that he had to do what he wanted. That was
fuck no, was it? That's why I was saying yesterday that what I wanted to say to him was, fuck no, man, I'm not doing that. But what I said was like, yeah. Okay, I just want to, I'm listening to it now. I hear all the popping, and I realize that these levels are probably way lower than that stuff. And I know that, okay, I'm just interrupting it to let you know that I know. If you're going to fucking tell me how much it popped in your ears, I'm sorry, okay? We're just fucking figuring this shit out. I'm going to continue the conversation with Steve. I know there's it's not the best, fucking whatever. Just listen. Yeah, no problem. I got it. I'll just watch your place and kill somebody if they come in. Where did you guys go? Do you know where you went?
You know, we went down to the most dangerous street in Fort Pierce, that where you do not go ever, especially at night.
Holy shit. I'm sorry. I'm breathing. I'm listening to that. I'm breathing like a fucking three-year-old who holds the phone. Just goes like, I was holding a device and then holding the phone up to it and trying to make sure that I was sounding. All right, I'm just going to keep playing it. I'm sorry to keep interrupting.
Night, and especially if you're white, you don't go there. And that's where I would go. That was just not cool at all. I didn't like it either, but I was the same as you. I was just trying to buy some weed, you know, I expected it to be at his house when we went to visit him. So when he said change of plans, we got to go somewhere, there was no turning back. You had to just go with it.
So you guys went to Avenue D, too, that time?
Yeah.
Fuck, man.
And I think we actually parked in a weird spot. He left me in the car, and we're walking and, like, disappeared in some crazy, you know, dark alley building.
That's got to be a bad feeling. That's a bad feeling, man.
Yeah, it was not cool. I was solo. I didn't have them nearby at that time. You know, that was not cool at all.
We were some dumb fucking white kids, man, doing that shit.
You know, you want to hear something worse?
What?
After that, my house.
Papa came to your house?
Yes, Papa came to my dad's house one time because he, after a while, he was like, you only come here to buy weed, but he considered us friends. He considered me a friend.
Yeah.
Bullshit, you know, and I said, like, on a whim, but you can come over anytime, and he took me up on it. He goes, all right, I'll be there tomorrow. And sure enough, and I, you know, I couldn't lie where I'm living at that point, but I still wanted to buy weed from him going forward. So, I, you know, I didn't expect to show up, and he showed up in Whitetown, USA, and we walked down the street, me and Pat looked like Bob Marley, hanging out. So that was crazy.
Now, did anybody, like, did your family, was your dad like, well, who's that guy? And you're like, that's Pat, Dad.
I was careful to try to, you know, keep him in and out fast, and kind of went out the side door. I don't think they met, I hope. I can't remember now, but.
Isn't that funny?
So weird.
Drug dealers, like, want to buddy up with you, you know? I don't mean just you. I mean in general. Like, drug dealers don't want to feel used just for their drugs. They want you to be their friend. Not you, you ass.
I'm not trying to say I'm likable, but I agree. But you're right. He definitely thought, you want to hear something else kind of funny. Back then, I was so worried about getting ripped off.
Yeah.
But if it wasn't exactly, I forget how many grams or an ounce or a quarter ounce or whatever the case is, but I knew it then, and I had this little portable scale I kept with me. And I actually busted it out, and, you know, it was a little alligator clip. I would clip it onto the plastic baggie, hold it in the air, and look to make sure it was, you know, pretty close to where it was supposed to be, which, you know, that was pretty ballsy for me to do that. But, I didn't think anything different. I pulled on Miami Vice and thought that was normal, you know?
That is ballsy as shit to do, man. Bust out a scale on drug dealers, like real drug dealers, be like, hey, man, you're a gram short. What's up with that? Do you remember that how we would cop like more of like a, we got more into wanting to go get weed, like when we saw like Menace to Society and shit, and we'd be like, what's up?
Oh, yeah.
We were like, let's go get a sack, man. And like, you don't know how hard it is for me growing up on these streets of Vero Beach.
Hey, I just thought I got all that out of my system young. You're right. We were lucky to make it out alive and be alive today.
And then now you became best friends with Papa, and then he was the best man at your wedding, right?
That's pretty funny. I would say no to that. Somehow or another, luckily, I was able to clear out of that. But I didn't get sucked in. I don't know how it ended or what, but somehow, thank God, the phone call. The last I heard from Papa was when I went off to school.
Wait, before you get to that, the other time, was we went down in your car and we rolled down Avenue D and we were surrounded by just dope dealers, and we had Pat in the back, and those guys all surrounded the car, and they're like, y'all look familiar, y'all been here before? And then I was like, no. And at the same time you were like, yeah, oh yeah, been here before.
Well, first you gotta put the backstory in place. When you go down this road, that's how the drug dealers work. You pull in the dark road, stop, and 10 or 15 guys start just swarming your window, your car windows, and reaching in your car, reaching at you.
Yeah.
Did you explain that last night or no?
Yeah, I mean, I was talking about, like, it's one of the rare, I mean, you know, depending on where you live, but it's one of the streets where there's no, like, there's not even an attempt to shield what they're doing. Like, they just walk out in the middle of the street, man.
I mean, there's three things on that street. There's hookers literally walking on the street. There's drug dealers that are just, plain as can be. And then there's one preacher man with his megaphone preaching everybody to get off the street.
Right.
And it was not cool. But anyway, we had all the people come up to our car and then, try to give us weed. And then one guy or two guys recognized the car. And that's when they asked us about, have you been here before? And my first instinct was to say, yeah, it's all good. And you're like, no, we both shook our heads the exact opposite at the same time.
Yeah, that was
so
beautiful.
Like assholes.
Yeah.
And then one guy's got his hand in his bag and like grabbing a gun. And all the time, we had no idea what the deal was, but I was so scared. The car was still in drive. My foot, I guess out of nervousness, started releasing the brake.
Yes.
Started rolling slowly. Looking more suspicious. And anyway, thank God Papa was there to talk him down, because we would have got shot for sure. My car looked just like someone that's just stealing weed, driving down, grabbing bags, not paying and hauling ass.
No, so. Pat saved our fucking life, man. I mean, he scared the shit out of me the first time I met him, but that, I'm telling you, man, if you're out there, Pat, thank you, man. Thank you for giving me life. Now, just to wrap this up, when was the last you ever heard is you went to college, right? You went away to college. We won't say where. And you're in school, and you get a phone call, right?
Yeah.
And what's
from
the
my mother.
From your mother.
Yeah, she asked me, she received a call from a detective. She didn't remember his name. She said, "Who's Poo Poo or Puff Puff?"
Hold on. Your mom says, "I got a phone call from detectives from the sheriff's department. Who is Poo Poo or Puff Puff?"
She didn't know the name. She couldn't remember either. And that's when I knew. I said, "Pat, Pat." She goes, "Yeah, that's it." And at that point, I'm backpedaling. I said, "Why? What's going on?" Reason being is Pat, this was before cell phones. I think we were even pagers probably back then. But he would write everybody's phone number that he deals with on his wall in his bedroom of his house. And, of course, my name and number was on the wall. So he obviously got popped for something bad. And the detectives were working backwards on everybody written on the wall, looking for me as one of his contacts or dealers or buyers. He called my mom, and my mom called me, and, luckily I got out of that one, too, but that was a close call.
I like how you had such a criminal answer. Like, your mom is calling you, and like, "Who's Poop Poop?" And you're like, "You mean Pat?" And she's like, "Yeah." And you're like, "Yeah, I don't know who that is. That's ridiculous, man. Dude, thanks, Steve. We will, I'll check in with you soon, man. I appreciate your time, and tell Pat we all said what's up, okay?
Hey, man, I'll be seeing him, I'm sure, right over the basement. I want him to know you say hey.
Hold on. Oh, man. Oh, Jesus. If you hated the audio quality of that, I fucking understand. Good Lord. Sorry. I did the best I could, man. I had to get Steve on to tell people that, you know, the Pat Pat shit, how it went down. That was such a crazy time, man. I keep thinking about that feeling of fear, too. God damn, I was scared to death. Trying to be cool. What's up, Pat Pat? I'm trying to get a sack, man. He's like, oh, you want to get a sack? I'll give you a sack. Put this sack in your mouth, motherfucker. So anyways, that was my good buddy Steve. And, yeah, hopefully we'll have... I got another Pat Pat story. We'll have to save that for some other time. I'm just sitting here. Do you know how good it is to have a washer in your house? I have a washer and dryer, not just a washer. But that shit is amazing. To just be able to fucking clean your filthy dick and ball and ass clothes. Not that you're always, not that that's the only thing that's on there, but it's a pretty cool feeling, man. I'm washing shit right now. I'm just excited about washing. So yeah, normally of course, the show will have another person, not just all these bites and clips. I have another one. You guys who listen to the show regularly know that my dad loves his McDonald's coffee. And when we got to see him last weekend, we brought it up. And he told us initially that he was boycotting McDonald's. And I was like, what? That's your favorite coffee. My dad thinks that McDonald's coffee is like premium, like other level shit. Like you could be like, this is the primo Colombian or Kenyan, whatever roast. It's $100 a fucking glass or a cup. And he'd be like, I don't want that shit because I can get my favorite stuff over here. He does not care. That shit is his favorite in the world. We went and talked to him about it, and I have a little plus. Oh, first I should do this. We got to look. We've spent a fucking fortune. To everybody that's ever purchased a Super Mommy Pack, thank you, because you helped do this. But the bills are fucking piling up, and so we have a sponsor. And yeah, I'm thankful. It's an awesome sponsor. It's Gamefly. I don't know if you guys have fucked with Gamefly. That's not a good way to start a promo, is it? Let's start that again. Sorry, Gamefly. No more F-bombs. I don't know if you've ever messed with Gamefly. But Gamefly is like Netflix for video games. So it's totally rad. They just deliver it right to your door. And it can even go directly into your system. So you can, it's like streaming. You can like streaming rent a game, which is crazy. They have, I don't know, over 8,000 titles, Call of Duty, Modern Warfare 3, Elder Scrolls. They got everything, man. There's no late fees, no shipping fees. It's a good way to just be able to listen or to try games and not have the obligation of buying them all. And here's the cool thing they're doing for our listeners. If you want to try out Gamefly, you can go to gamefly.com/mom, M-O-M, and you get a free 15-day trial. So you can give it a shot. You can see if these games are games you want to play. You can use them. You can manipulate and use the system. That's what happens when you give away free trials. You can sign up for the free trial, test the engine, take it for... It's basically they're giving you the keys to the car, and they're like, bring it back in 2 weeks, and then you can take it, and you can throw it violently at them at the end, or you can be like, I like this. I want to do this more. So that's the spot. Gamefly.com/mom, M-O-M. You get a free 15-day trial. Thank you, Gamefly. Thank you, everybody that tries it. Again, please help me pay for this Behringer soundboard that I've spent too much money on. Thank you. All right. Now, did you like that commercial break? Did you not? I don't know. And by the way, I hate myself so much for trying to listen to... I know it was hard to listen to the Steve call. I could hear the volume. I was holding it. It was a fucking disaster. I recognize that. Don't tell me that. I already know that. I don't need you to tell me how badly that went. Okay? So anyways... There's that. And don't forget that you can hopefully check out the website, and there's a lot of cool stuff on the site. YourMomsHousePodcast.com is the site, and you can, we have little mommies, which is what we call you, have a lot of cool stuff that you've submitted. It's just, it's a beautiful thing, man. It's a wonderful thing to be a mommy, and we have a place where you can reach out to us. You can give us your would you rathers. You can give us your scenarios. You can tell us to go fuck ourselves. You can do whatever you want. So I'm looking at your emails right now, and look, there's Valentine's Day poems, would you rathers. It's all kinds of shit here, man. I fucking love it. So anyways, back to my dad and his McDonald's coffee. Again, what's this going to sound like? I don't know what it's going to sound like. I'm going to play it for you, and this is really him. You're going to hear Top Dog, that's what we call him, talking about McDonald's coffee. And yeah, here's what he really sounds like.
I love their coffee.
Yeah. So you're boycotting McDonald's?
Yeah, well, I love their coffee. In fact, it's the best coffee.
Right.
But they've gone to two drive-through lanes.
Yeah.
And so what happened is, I mean, timed it, mm-hmm. that the lanes, the other day it took me 13 minutes to get my coffee through the drive-thru.
Yeah.
And because even though they have two lanes, they don't process it as fast as they should. So that's, so from a customer point of view, it's actually taking longer. And I talked to them about that.
And what do you do when you talk to them? How have you talked to them?
Well, I call the 1-800 McDonald's number in Illinois, and they're very nice, and they, you know, they... I think they're generally concerned, but I've noticed this in a couple other. So now I go to McDonald's that have single lines, not.
So you're not, but you said you were boycotting.
Well, I'm not really boycotting. What I'm doing,
but
is
you're boycotting the dual lane.
Dual lanes. Yeah.
Dual lane McDonald's do not get your business.
Dual lane McDonald's don't get my business. I only go to single lane McDonald's.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Now because that one is not convenient for me, I'm not going as much as I used to.
That's adorable.
And do you have a favorite employee at the single lane McDonald's like you did at the other one?
No, I haven't really cultivated.
That's not a joke. That's real. I love my dad, man. He is the fucking best. He really loves that coffee. Do you know somebody like that who has, like, they just have, like, such an affinity for some product that it's just not even, there's no balance to it. Doesn't even make sense. Like, you're like, that's not even the best shit that's out there. And they're like, no, it is, though. It really is. You haven't had this type of seasoning before. Like, no, I have. I tried it, man. It's not as good as it gets. Yes, it is. That is not, you don't know anything. People get excited, man, about their, whatever they like. That's, fuck, it's weird. I have some interview, man, I don't even know how to explain this. I was with my parents and Christina, and I have some audio of my parents that is going to blow your mind. I can't play it. I can't do it on this episode. It's too good to not have Christina here. Like, if she's not here, it doesn't even make sense, man. Do you know what I mean? Like, I can't enjoy it as much as I would without her. So I can't play it. I am going to go into your emails right now. This is not as prepared as I would like to be, but let's see. Let's see if I can pull up something for you. I want to give you a quality show. Let's see. Who is this from? Brandon sent a would you rather. Would you rather take your big fat cock and lather it with rotten meat and glory hole it into a cage full of starving lions? I can't wait to see what the other side of this is, man. Because so far, it's pretty good. Or slice your big fat cock longitudinally. Is it a knife? That sounds fucking wrong. With an knife. Fill it with tacks, salt, and vinegar, sew it up, and then have your buddy hit it with a hammer. That is fucking terrible, man. What is wrong with you? What is wrong with you? That is not... That's actually exactly how you play the game. It's supposed to be terrible scenarios. And that is fucking terrible. It looks like either way... I mean, well, here's the thing. I'm not going to... I'm going to take the salt and vinegar. That's a horrible... Where do you come up with this? The Lions, you're going to lose it for sure. You're gonna lose it in a violent, awful way. It's gonna be terrible. So I'm not doing that. That is a terrible, terrible, terrible way to have your dick lost. The other way you get to keep it, but it seems like I don't know. It seems weird. All right, that was really weird. All right, somebody else. Hey, what's up, Mitchell? I am gonna respond to you about that. Okay. What is this here? Recent. All right. Who would you rather be caught masturbating every day by a family member or all your family and friends and your spouse are at the delivery room and your baby comes out black? Okay. You realize that you're implying with your would you rather that the worst thing ever would be to have a black baby. That's interesting. Very revealing thing from you. I won't give out your name to protect you. I would rather be caught masturbating every day by a family member, though, because that would be terrible if Christina had a black baby. What I don't know who sent that one in. Would you rather have to give blowjobs to a group of marathon runners or have the guys of the Jersey Shore fuck you to a soundtrack of awful rap music? That's terrible, man. That's Derek. Thanks, Derek. I think this goes back to which is more tolerable if you're not gay to do that's clearly gay. And I think I got to say, I mean, they're awful, but I still feel like blowing dudes is gayer than getting railed. Like, it's not just gay. Like, it's you are performing the act. It's just, it's, you can't, nah, I guess bring it on, fucking Mikey D and whatever the other one is. Situation. I bet he would wear glasses and make it a whole show. He would. He would do weird shit the whole time. Let's see. Oh, here's an interesting one. Would you rather know where the dudes are at or never be able to tell anyone? That is such a good question. That is from Kip. It's so relevant. Man, I don't know, dude. I don't know. I would rather know where they're at. But you know that's not going to happen. There's only one guy that knows where the dudes are at. And his name is Casey. And he hasn't told us. He hasn't told us where they're at. God damn, Casey. Would it be that hard to fucking give it up, Case? Would it be that hard to give it up? I don't think it would be. He's so selfish, man. He is so selfish. Oh, wow. Thanks a lot for that, man. For those of you who don't know, Casey is a friend of mine, and he knows. He knows where they're at, man. He just knows.
That's a cool plan. You go to the Pasadena Ice House, and you get in a good mood and have a few drinks, and like I said, where are the dudes at? How do you know where the dudes are at?
What?
Where are the dudes at?
Okay.
That makes me laugh every time. Oh, fuck. That's Monkey Todd. Monkey Todd asking, what's his name? Harvey? The TMZ guy, where the dudes are at? That's the funniest shit I've ever heard, man. That makes me so happy. All right, we're going to wrap this up. We, meaning me alone, sitting here not knowing how equipment works, hating myself for not knowing what this is going to sound like. I hope this worked for you. It's going to be longer and better. And we're working through problems. Video is coming. Fucking video is coming. By the time you see this, by the time this is up, we'll probably have video fully functioning. Right now, it is what it is, man. I'm just doing the best I can. All right. I'm about to wrap this up. What else did I want to tell you? Did I want to tell you something else? I don't know. We love you. Thank you for listening. Also, something new happened. By the time this is up, let's see. I'll be in Louisville, Kentucky, at the end of March, the last weekend in March. I'm in Louisville, Kentucky. April and May, I'm going a lot of places. That's a weird way, but I'll be in Kansas City. I'll be in Hartford. I'll be somewhere. I just burped. Could I be less prepared for this? Fuck it. Just go to TomSegura.com. I'll keep it as good as I can updated. I don't even make any sense, man. But yeah, I'm going there. I'm doing New York. I'm doing Gotham Comedy Club in May. I'm doing other places as well. I'm looking at Christina's calendar. By the time this is up, you might be able to see her in San Diego in March. I'm doing that club in May. It's the American Comedy Company. She's doing Gildafest in Michigan, March 15th through 17th. And there's a lot of places you could see her. And go to ChristinaComedy.com. All right, I gotta wrap this shit up. What did I want to leave on? An oldie but goodie, a classic. What do we do here? Help me fucking figure this out. I don't know what's going on. Not that. No. I gotta figure this out. I'm sorry. Let's see. I'm trying to. I don't know what anything is anymore. What is that? That's wrong. That can't be right. I hope you didn't hear that. I think you did. It's another video I'm working on. Is this me just breathing? How do you like that? How do you feel about breathing? Is it something you're into? You like hearing guys breathe? I'm good at it. Clearly, you heard my fucking stupid ass breathing. And God damn, I hate myself for that. All right. I'm going to get out of here. I love you. I thank you for listening. I hope that we can do this a lot more. And you can tune in. Hopefully, we want to do this shit like 2-3 times a week. And we're going to do it as much as we can. All right? So, a lot of love. And I will be with you. I don't know what I'm saying. I got to look for buttons to press now. I got to go.
Shit, I break kids, step into my zone, mad rhymes will stifle ya. Lines like rifles go blast when I kick some ass. A lot of rappers be like one-time wonders. Couldn't say a fly rhyme if there was one right under their noses. I hate those